Hello everyone, my name is Derek Matlar, and I have one question for you. What do you do when the balloons take over the world? Well, obviously you train monkeys to pop them. Today I'm going to be showing you how to play Balloon Tower Defense 5. I will be going over placement techniques, strategies, other ways to help you get to level 100 and beyond. So the first monkey you're given is called a dark monkey. And I'm playing on easy just because I'm not going to try to on a time crunch. So you want to put the first one here and you want to hit go. And as you can see, right here is where you will learn new techniques for your monkey. So they can throw it farther, they'll be sharper. And look at that, I just got a new one. It's called a tack shooter. Cool thing about the tack shooter is now we got to learn something new. While the dark monkey is based on precision, the tack shooter is based upon area. Area is good in corners, hence the gray circle around it. So as my dark monkey's not strong enough, we are about to see how powerful it can get. Now, how this game works is it's a survival game, basically, where you have a limited, it will go on forever, and your goal is to last out as far as you can. There are some elements to keep in mind. For number one, this red right here is your health. I can get up to 200 red balloons to here, and then I lose. Also, the gold right here is your money. You get one, for every one red pop, you get $1. And for a basic dart monkey, that's $170. And as you can see, I didn't plan correctly. Now I'm gonna take two hits. Now, something you should be prepared for is that eventually the game will get harder. As you can see, there are now blue balloons. Blue balloons now take two hits to pop. Now the goal is to double up like I did with them, and then change from first to strong. Because now they're both gonna fire upon the blue ones, making them red and then weakening them. Now we go into one of the other ones, placement. There are a few monkeys where this doesn't apply to. This would be the sniper. I can put the sniper anywhere on the board and it will always fire. If I were to put let's say a dart monkey over here, it wouldn't hit anything because this gray area is where it can attack. So you always want to keep that in mind, is placement. If you put it in the wrong spot, it's absolutely useless. Put it in the right spot, it can be very effective. Now this is gonna take forever, and I understand everyone's gonna get bored. So instead what I have is I have me farther down the road at level, hold on, I'm at rank 69, and I'm at round 50 of 50. As you can see, I have a lot more money. A couple of them make pop culture references, Super Monkey, Superman, Magician, Tack, and then we run into our Moabs, Mother of All Balloons. Now, if you're not prepared for this, this balloon will absolutely wreck you. Yeah. Unfortunately, it's only one of three. There's also Moab, and then you have BFG. Forget the F, but it's not a cuss word, giant. And it's a red one, and then there's the Z. It's the Zeppelin, oh my god. And if, unless you know how to strategically plan and place your monkeys, you will not do well. And as you go on, you'll see other balloons. You'll see black balloons, which are immune to, look at that, I just finished my track. Now that you're going into overtime. Sorry, I skipped around there. But there are different types of balloons. For example, black balloons are immune to explosions, white are immune to frost, ceramic can take a ton of hits. So, all right, that's it.